Hi everyone, and thanks for joining me this evening. I'm Chanel and I am an independent stamping up demonstrator here in the UK, and I am here today, or this evening I should say, with this gorgeous card tutorial. It is my second video today, but I thought I would spoil you, as you are always there for me. So I am back. Oh, what's going on here? Right, okay, so we are going to make this absolutely amazing card using the Timeless Tropical stamp set. Let me just get you up on my screen so I can see who's here with me. Okie dokie. And so I can say hello to you. Hi Julie, hi Tracy, hi Lynn, hi Denise. How are you all? Right, okay, so this is the card and matching envelope. Feeding the Beasts. Hi Gemma, hi Vanda. And this is the inside of the card. And don't forget, at the end of this video, I will be giving away one of these cards to one of you that has commented and has watched the video. A little treat from me. This morning we gave away a wonderful gift card holder. Right, okay, so. Hi, Kay. Oh, my daughter's watching. Hiya. Not like her to watch my video. She's normally busy running around after the kids at this time of the evening. So, right, okay, so we're going to be making this wonderful, wonderful. Oh, Lynn says she's still on the Baileys. Oh my gosh, Lynn, you started on the Baileys at 2 o'clock this afternoon. I'm surprised you're still watching. Hi, Karen, honey. Right, okay, so we're making this gorgeous card. We are using the Timeless Tropical stamp set and the coordinating in the tropics dies. It's one that's in the catalogue, and you know, really it's a summery kind of set, but actually not, doesn't have to be. There are some beautiful images on there, and the dies make it super easy to create something very beautiful. Right, okay, so what we're going to need for this project, apart from the stamp sets, so we're going to need an envelope, we're going to need the Scripty embossing folder as well, and we have a card base here, and then we have our layers, which are this one here is 4 by 5 3/8, that's basic black, 4 by 5 3/8, and then we've got 3 7/8 by 5 1/4, and I have actually gone and run that through the embossing folder to save time, so that's already done and good to go. And then you're going to need some scrap pieces of Whisper White. And this is a strip of Whisper White, which is cut at 1/2 inch. Don't ask me how long it is cut at, because I can't tell you. Right, okay, so let's do some stamping before we do anything else. We're going to need our envelope. We're going to need our card. And we're going to need some Whisper White. So, why don't we go ahead and do the inside of the card first. Let me just move that to one side. We're going to be using Melon Mambo ink. I've also got Flirty Flamingo, but this is for the distressing. And then we are using Old Olive for the leaves. So let me get my, we're using Melon Mambo for the flower outlines. The script embossing folder looks fab. It is one of my favorites. It's probably actually the one embossing folder that I've actually used the most out of all my embossing folders, actually. Right, so we're just going to do, I'm just going to make sure I'm in shot. And we're just going to do the flower down here. What did Moira ask? Why does it always offer me a translation of your comments, Cameron? Oh, right, okay, so we're just going to do the flower in there. And we're going to do the flower, little flower, on the envelope now. If you are going to stamp on an envelope, sometimes the ink can bleed through. So just get a scrap piece of card and put it in where you're going to stamp, basically. So that's just a little tip for you. And if you're going to be doing some colouring, blending on them especially, not so bad when you do inks, but I always do it anyway. But if you're going to blend and colour that in, which we're not, but if we were, then definitely put your bit of paper inside. You don't really need it for the inks, but I was just showing you as a little tip. Okay, so that's our envelope done. Oopsie-daisy. And then we also have our, oh gosh, while I've got my Melon Mambo out, concentration now. Do you know, I lose concentration so easily, it's not even funny. Right, okay, so we're going to do one of the big flowers, like so, just like that, just like that. And then we're going to do one of the smaller flowers. Well, I didn't realise until I did it, and then it went, it bled through. So I found out the hard way. Right, okay, so that's all you're going to need your Melon Mambo for, I think. And then what we might as well do is do our leaves. So we're going to need 3 leaves. It's the fibromyalgia. Yes, I think it is. My lack of concentration. Either that or it's old age, Julie. You being younger than me, you don't have that problem. Right, okay, so we're just going to do 3 leaves. I do love these leaves. They are just gorgeous. Honestly, I love these leaves. Look at these beautiful, beautiful images. Aren't they just gorgeous? And you'll see in a minute when we use the blender pens that you don't even really need to do that much blending on them because of the gorgeous detail in the images. Right, okay, and then let's put this away. Plus it's getting a bit later on in the day, so I do tend to lose my concentration then as well. Right, we've got our sentiments, we might as well do that. You ain't old. I am old. I'm older than you. Right, so just got our sentiment here, and I'm going to pull this down a little bit so I can try. I'm going to have to pull it right down to get it straight, I'm afraid. I don't even know if that was in shot, and look, I missed. I flipping missed. Right, turn it over. Right, that's why I have to come right down. I'm so sorry, guys. I can't, there you go. I had to pull my head right down because it's only a skinny strip, and if I don't do that, then I'm not going to get it in shot. I know that for sure. Right, and then we've got the sentiment inside, which is just gorgeous. May your birthday be memorable. And the script, as usual, is just the font, I should say, is just wonderful. Right, let's pull this up here, get this straight. And then we've done all of our stamping, I think. Try not to forget anything today. So that's the inside of the card done. That's the envelope done. And we're going to do a little bit of blending. And like I said, you don't really need to do an awful lot. And look at these lovely colours together. Aren't they just gorgeous? This is the Flirty Flamingo and the Old Olive. And aren't they just super gorgeous together? They're just lovely, aren't they? Just lovely. So, right, we're going to take the Old Olive inks, and we're going to use the Light Old Olive. And we're just going to, I go around the edge first. Love Old Olive. I think it's my favorite green. And so we're just going to come in here, and I always do the edges first, especially when there's a sort of bit of a jaggedy jaggedy edge here. And then you can just color in the leaves like that. Now You could just leave that as it is because of the detail already in the stamp. I'm only going to do one because I have done all the others. And then but you could take the dark old olive and just follow the stamped image just to give it a little bit more detail if you want to, like that. And then just come in and blend these in together, and you'll find that that's even more, there's even more detail on that. But really, on these stamps, you could just go over it and not have to worry. You don't really have to worry too much about that on these stamps. So then we're going to take the Flirty Flamingo, the light one, and we're going to do exactly the same with the flowers. Oh, bless you. Trust me, practice. It is practice, honestly. Just remember when you was a kid and you've got to stay in the lines. These are being cut out, but you still want to try and be tidy. But there are two different ends on these, on the blenders. So you don't have to use the brushed edge. You can use the brush tip. You can use the bullet point tip. And then we're just going to come in and see, look, takes seconds. And then we're going to do exactly the same again where this is highlighted. I'm just going to come in and just do a little bit of colour. Oh, bless. I don't like the fussy cutting, I must admit. I'm not a fan. I'm not a fan of fussy cutting. And then look, you just shade that in. And then we're just going to colour, just blend. I'm going over that, what I coloured in, and you can see. There you go, 2 dozen gnomes to practice on. Oh my gosh, well, you're going to love me. You are going to love me because this is our card for tomorrow. Look at him. Isn't he gorgeous? Very quick and easy card this one is. This is what we're going to call a mass production card, because you know you get some cards which are not mass production. You don't want to sit there and do loads and loads and loads of some cards. Well, this one is definitely you can mass produce these cards very, very, very simply. So this is tomorrow's card. Isn't it super cute? Right, okay, and we're just going to do exactly the same thing with the big flower. I won't bore you with colouring it. We've just done exactly the same thing. We've just coloured the main bit in the Flirty Flamingo light, and then I've just highlighted some of these areas, okay? So, and then what we're going to do is you need to die cut all of these pieces out, and through the magic of television, I have them already done. Yes, I do. Dun, dun. All done, because they are magic dies. Right, let's move that over there, and we're going to put this card together. If I can find all my bits. Right, okay, just get my basic black. Who's gorgeous? Oh, he's gorgeous. He's gorgeous. I've just finished a mass production run. I wondered if he was talking about Matthew McConaughey then, or what's his name that did Sherlock Holmes. I think he's lovely. Oh, Cumberbatch. I was a, I don't know if I can say it on camera, a fan, shall we say. There was a nickname for fans of him. I forgot his first name now. Oh, look, that's not on straight. We've got quite a big gap around here. It's 2/8 of an inch around there. And we're going to put down our embossed piece. Oh my gosh, what was his name? Cumberbatch. Oh my gosh, how could I forget his name? See, it's because it's a bit later on in the day. I am losing the plot. Benedict. Oh, how could I forget Benedict? Benedict. No, I think the love of my life has always been Barry Manilow and Matthew McConaughey. But some of Matthew McConaughey's films, he looks like a scruff bag. But some of them, he looks gorgeous. Like How to Lose a Guy. Oh my gosh, I must have watched that film like 50 million times. Who's the other one I really like? Oh, I don't know. I've had a lot of crushes throughout the years. Right, okay. So what we're going to do is, I'm sorry, I'm waffling now. We're going to just position our leaves. We're going to pop them and just position them first before we stick them down. Just so we can see where we're going to put this. Like, I want to move this down a bit, a little bit. It doesn't matter if they're not perfect. Right, now the card I saw on Pinterest didn't have the center flower, so you could actually just leave it as it is, like that. You don't have to put the one in the center if you don't want to. You might prefer it like that. It's just I wanted to put something in the center and it didn't look quite right on this card, so that's why I added the extra flower, so I could put the bit in the middle. But this one you could leave it as it is, just like that really, if you wanted to. Right, okay, let us get some dimensionals going. Right, so we're just going to put a couple of dimensionals on each one. Honestly, Lynn, if I had a brain, I'd be dangerous. Oh, bless. That's one of my sayings. It's a very elegant card. I mean, I could leave it. Shall I leave this one without the center so I can show you the two different styles? We just won't be able to put a thing in the middle because I don't think it looks right. So we're just going to pop that there. I kind of like them both ways, if I'm honest. And I think I'm not going to put that down yet. Let me just make sure. Oh, that's right. Let me have a look. Might move it down just a little bit more. There you go. And then that one over there. I don't know. We could see what it looks like when we've finished and see if what we prefer. And then what we're going to do is just stick a couple of dimensionals. Now, because you've already got the leaves raised up, you only really want to put dimensionals on one half and then glue these other two. So I always put my fingers where I know to glue and put the dimensionals on the other side. Oops. There you go. So we're just... Oopsie. So who is going to win the card, I wonder? Like I said, it is just me picking one of you at random. Not random, but one of you, because I can't put your names in a hat because it would just take me too long to write all your names down. See, it just looks so gorgeous. It looks... I think I'm going to leave it because just to give you the... you know, the two different ones. Right, so we're going to be using the banner punch, pick a banner punch, I think it is. And what we're going to do, I'm just going to trim this off very slightly because I think one has a little bit more white than the other, so I'm just going to trim that off just a little bit. Hi Tracy, honey, I didn't know you was there. You snuck up on me. Right, we're going to push that in, but still look to make sure that it's even on the other side. Otherwise, you can, even though it's in the channel, it can sometimes go out a little bit. Ooh, see, I kind of want to move that over. Oh, I always do that, always move it over too far. Okay, right. And what I'm going to do, oh gosh, sorry about that, just to highlight it a little bit, is to take the Flirty Flamingo and a sponge, because obviously it's white on white, so you kind of want it to pop out a little bit. Ooh, I've got ink all over my fingers. Should have used my peg trick, shouldn't I? There you go, so we've highlighted that. So it's going to just give it a little bit of a pop. And I used these gorgeous gilded gems. I've not used these before. It's the first time I've used them. And they are just, oh, look at those, how blingy they are. Right, so we're going to stick some dimensionals on these. Like so. And like so. And like so. And like so. Huh. I know, it's always you getting, you always a messy pup with the ink, Julie. Oh my gosh, yes, Julie, you are messy. You're a mucky pup. Right, so we're just going to, oops, that's not central. Get off, get off, get off. Move it over just slightly. There you go. And that's that, like that. And then we're just going to take some of the gems. And I want to put one of these on either end of the centre. Oh gosh, my gem slipped. Oh look, that's left a mark on there now. Oh, I must have had ink on my pokey tool. Right, there you go. Is that straight? Yes, it is. Do you know what? I didn't even check that I put that down. Make sure when you're putting scripty down that you've got it the right way round. Thank God I did. And I think I'm just going to stick one up here and leave it at that, I think. I don't think I'm going to do any more to it, because sometimes you can just get carried away and then the simplicity of it you lose. Hi Janet, honey, isn't that just gorgeous? So that's two ways of doing it. That's ways obviously with putting the little flower, and that's with using just the flower image. And of course that's the envelope. Aren't they just gorgeous? This is a beautiful set, and loving the colors. So another set which I hadn't used, I'm trying to work my way through my sets. I could be here all year, I think, because I've still got lots more. Tomorrow we are going to be doing a very quick card, which is one which is great for mass production. So we're going to be using the Gnome for the Holidays stamp set tomorrow. And also, what else was I going to say? Right, I know what I was going to say. Who is going to win the card? Okay, I won't do a drum roll or a fanfare, because my fanfare was a bit pants earlier on today when I did one. So I think, for entertainment purposes, I am going to give the card to the wonderful Lindy, because she's very entertaining and she was in pain earlier. So I'm going to give the card to our lovely Lynn. 11 a.m. Yes, 11 a.m. I will be here at 11 o'clock in the morning, and it will be a quickie. Well, it sounds wrong, doesn't it? That would be a quickie. Oh, I must tell you, I have some exciting news to tell you. Some of you might already know it, but I do have some exciting news, and I can now tell you all. I've been bursting to tell you all, but I couldn't, and you'll hear why in a minute. But as you all know, I've had some, you know, quite not so nice things going on recently, which have been not so good. But there has also been something very amazing and wonderful that has happened. As you know, I am a grandmother of four beautiful, beautiful grandchildren. Well, a couple of months ago, my daughter found out she is expecting. They are expecting. I am going to be a grandmother again. Yes, I am. And they've announced it today, officially. So I now can tell you all. I've just been bursting with joy to tell you all my news. So much has been going on in the past couple of months, and that is something good that has been happening rather than something not so good. So yes, that is my news. Isn't that exciting? So well done, Lynn, honey, for winning your card. And I will be here at 11 o'clock tomorrow morning. So that will be another quick tutorial. There is a second part to my news, by the way. Would you all like to know what the second part to my news is? Yes, I have more news. Would you all like to know my more news? Oh my goodness me. And you all need to be sat down for this one. Are you all sitting down? You need to be sat down for my news. Are you all sat down? Keeping you all waiting. Keeping you all waiting. Right. So, it's twins. It's twins. My daughter's having twins. Yes. I've only just picked myself up off the floor, like, you know, yes. So, yes, she's having twins in March. Well, that's when they're due. So, yes, how wonderful and what joyous news. So yes, I'm going to be very, very busy in March. So I'm just giving you the heads up now, guys. I'll probably have to schedule some videos because for a few weeks I am going to be on call. Yes, we've got twins coming. Very exciting. In 3 weeks' time, we are going to find out what they are. Yes, so that's super exciting. Something to look forward to. Right, I'm not going to keep you for any longer. I will see you all tomorrow morning at 11. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please share my videos because that's how we get more group members. And you know, please tell everyone about the lovely work that we do on the group and share, share, share. So if you have crafty friends, please invite them to the group. I don't know if you knew that you can actually go on to the group and invite your friends. So please, please, please invite so we can grow our group even bigger. I love you guys and I will see you all tomorrow. Have a lovely evening. Take care. Bye.